Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. We're not cooking in Betty's Kitchen tonight. We're going out to dinner. This is the wedding anniversary of Rick and me. It's the 44th wedding anniversary because we got married on January 23rd, 1970 on a cold, snowy night, which is what we have for our anniversary. Always we have cold, snowy nights. This year, it's particularly cold. The high today was 8 degrees, and it's going down to below zero tonight with wind chills at 10 below. So we decided to venture out and go to a nice restaurant in town. It is called Hangers, and we have gone there twice before and shown it on YouTube. Once was for a lunch, and another time was for a derby party, but we've never taken you to dinner, so we thought you might like to come along and see our dinner that we're having for our 44th wedding anniversary. Now, we do have some gifts for each other, so we're going to pause for a moment, get those gifts, and unwrap them and let you see them before we go.
Betty has my present here. A nice little gift bag with a pretty little sloop on it. Card. Loving you is the most natural thing in the world for me. To Rick, thanking you for making me the luckiest person in the whole world for the past 47 and a half years. We dated for about 3.5 years before we got married. Love, Shine. I feel so lucky to have found the one person in the world who is so right for me, you. I love you always, Shine. Thank you, darling. And what do we have here? DVDs of the complete box set of The Prisoner. Patrick McGowan box set shows that came out in, I think, the late 60s that I really enjoyed back then. They had a remake, a reboot. It wasn't nearly as long as the miniseries a couple of years ago. I didn't care for it as much as I remembered the original, so I'm going to really enjoy these. Hope you'll watch them with me. Thank you, Betty.
You're welcome. Rick has given me a card. It says, to Shine. Shine is my nickname from him. And it says, Destiny, Fate, Kismet. Let's see. Inside it says, We Were Meant to Be. To my one and only girl, all my love, to Betty from Rick. Thank you. And here is the gift he's giving me. And I will say that my philosophy is that good things come in small satin pouches. So let's open this up. Oh, a necklace, and let me get it to stop swirling around. And this is what it looks like. That's nice. It actually matches a ring that I got a couple of years ago. Well, it was Christmas before last, so he's matched it up with the necklace or the pendant on a small silver, oh, I guess this is white gold chain. So I think I'll go change my necklace and wear this one tonight, and I'll see you at the restaurant. Thank you, Rick. I was so busy thinking that I was going to put this on, I forgot to thank you. I love it.
Great.
We've just arrived at Hangers, and we came inside, and it's nice and cozy in here. There's even a fireplace, so that's really nice, and our table is just about 6 feet away from the fireplace. So I'm going to have a seat, and we'll wait for our server to come, and then we'll be having an appetizer. Our server has brought my iced tea, and Rick has just water with lemon. So we're all set with that, and we're looking to order an appetizer. On the first page, it's called Previews, right here. And on the left side is a cheese board, and it gives various kinds of cheese that you might like. I don't think I'll do that, and I don't think Rick is interested in that. For previews, I'll just give you an example or two. There is tuna tutaki, which I'm not familiar with, cheese fondue, hotsi totsis, which are mozzarella wrapped in wontons and fried. I think I'll get that. It's served with mango chutney for dipping. And the next column is extras. So if you want whipped potatoes or baked potato, sweet potato, a lot of different things. And down at the bottom is soup, which is tomato bisque cup. I get a cup or a bowl. And then on the next page, there are all sorts of salads. Over on the right-hand side are sandwiches. We didn't really come for a sandwich tonight necessarily, so probably will not do those. The bottom of the page shows entrees. I looked at these on the internet. I looked at Hanger's website and looked at a menu. And I really like the idea of chicken cordon bluegrass. So I think that's probably what I'm going to get. Rick, have you decided what you're going to get?
Yes.
What is it?
It's not there. It's over on the pasta side.
Okay. He's getting pasta. And what kind are you getting?
Probably their classic chicken Alfredo. It's somewhere down here.
It's at the very bottom. Classic grilled chicken Alfredo. It has red pepper, fettuccine smothered in peppery, garlic, butter, and Parmesan cream sauce. That sounds delicious. I want you to see what this room looks like. We're the only ones in the room, and we've been waiting about 15 minutes or so for our appetizers. And actually, they have just arrived, so we're going to show you the appetizers in just a moment. But this is a pleasant atmosphere and has nice music. It's not crowded, not a lot of people talking or anything like that. So it's really a delightful place to come if you want to have a nice romantic dinner.
Hey, what have you got?
Okay, now here is my appetizer, and you knew I was going to get the Hotsy Totsies. Here's what they look like. These are wonton wrappers, and inside them you have mozzarella cheese, and they have been deep fried. And this is mango chutney here at the end. Looks like two different kinds of dressing, but all that was listed on the menu was mango chutney. We're going to let Rick tell you about his, so he's going to pass the camera over to me.
You take the boy out of the country, but you can't take the country out of the boy. And the thing that really appealed to me, for whatever reason, was chicken wings and the appetizer menu. So I got the order of 10 chicken wings. They are dry rubbed, which I like better than the really wet, kind of greasy ones, with a ranch dressing. And I'll probably eat two or three or maybe four and save the rest for lunch tomorrow.
They look good, don't they?
They do.
I'm really enjoying my Hotsy Totsies, and I want to tell you that this sauce is a marinara sauce, and the other one is the mango chutney. And I prefer the sweeter sauce, so I'm going to put some on here. And I've already eaten one of these, so I'm going to take a bite for you. That's a really great combination of flavors.
I won't say I'm a wing expert, but I do like them. I do eat them with some regularity. These are very good. You don't often see the dry rub wings. Usually they're just dripping with this butter and hot sauce, buffalo sauce, which I like too, but I know that's got so much calories and fat that I feel a little guilty. But this doesn't. Also, the ranch sauce is really rich and deep, and that's really surprisingly how good that is to me. The waitress brought us some bread and my side salad, which is a Caesar salad. The bread looks like it's a toasted French baguette, might be called crostini. There's some whipped butter there, piped out into a little bowl. And this is my Caesar salad, which is a side salad to go with my pasta, but it's pretty large salad, looks like to me. So that looks good. Shall I enjoy it?
I think that does look good. Here's my entree. I have the chicken cordon bluegrass, and if you're wondering about that name, Kentucky is the bluegrass state. And by that, the meaning is that a lot of people plant grass that is bluegrass. It actually is green in color, but it has a blue cast to it. So that's why this is called the bluegrass state. And as a play on that, they've taken chicken cordon bleu and called it chicken cordon bluegrass. So it's bluegrass style. So that's that. And here we have a baked potato. I asked to have all my toppings on the side because I wanted to decide how much I was going to use of each. I have butter and then shredded cheddar cheese. I have sour cream with chives on it and bacon crumbled. And this is to go with my side here, which is asparagus. This is hollandaise, and the asparagus already has a little relish there with it, which is a combination of celery and some other things. But the hollandaise sauce I wanted on the side so that I could decide how much of it I was going to use. So let's see what Rick has.
I ordered the classic grilled chicken Alfredo. And here it is. There's a nice big chicken breast. Well, a big piece of chicken. There's several pieces. There's the linguine, I think it was called. There's a nice piece of bread that's covered with the Parmesan and spices. And that looks very good.
Just to update you on my entree, I've had a little bit of the asparagus with hollandaise sauce. It tastes wonderful. And I've begun to eat my baked potato. I don't think I'll finish all of it, but I have used a little bit of all four toppings, and that's great. I've been eating around the edges of my chicken cordon bluegrass, and I am trying to get to the center to see the stuffing because I can see a little cheese that has run out there. But in the middle, it's really crunchy on the edge. But you can see that there is a filling inside. And I'm expecting that would be ham and cheese. I haven't really gotten that far, but I'm going to take a little bite from the center. See if I can identify this. I'm going to say it's country ham, and seems to be something like cheddar cheese. I can't say for sure, but there usually is a slice of ham and a slice of cheese in your chicken cordon bleu. And this is chicken breast that has been pounded thin and coated with a very crispy type coating and deep fried, or maybe fried in a skillet, shallow fried. It's all really good.
I've been tasting away at my chicken Alfredo until it's almost gone. And it's very good. It's a very nice grade of Parmesan cheese, you can tell, in there, and rich creamy sauce. I'm sure it's made with cream as well. And the noodles are linguine kind of noodles, I think. And it's very tasty. I've enjoyed it.
You may have noticed that a few people have shown up, and there is a little bit of noise in the room, but I think you can hear me. We just received our desserts, and here's what I ordered. This is bread pudding, and it has a warm bourbon sauce, and I can see pecans as well. So it's a very southern, very Kentucky style dish. I think I'll enjoy that. I'll share it with Rick. Now he has ordered this dessert, which is a dark chocolate mousse. And the mousse is made with Myers rum. So I'm sure it's very delicious. It has some nuts and whipped cream and a strawberry on the top. I'm taking a little taste of Rick's chocolate mousse. Mmm, that's wonderful. Very smooth. It's very dark chocolate. And you can taste that rum in there too. It's excellent. Now I'm going to also take a taste of my dessert, which was the bread pudding with the warm bourbon sauce. I want to get a pecan, a little bit, and some of the bread, and some of the sauce. I think I've got it, I'm not sure. Yes, I got the pecans and the bread and the sauce. You have to like bourbon in order to like this, but I love it. It tastes wonderful. It's perfect for this bread pudding. So I think you would enjoy making something like this if you ever run across a recipe for bread pudding. This finishes out our 44th wedding anniversary meal. So I'm going to be saying goodbye to you. And I just want you to know that we'll see you in the next video. And we've had a wonderful day and continue to do so.